The LS1 and LS Core consoles offer up to 8 universes of DMX over sACN or 4 over ArtNet. Still, either way, you're going to get more than just the 2 on the back of the console if you set up some ArtNet nodes or other devices. But how do you set up sACN or ArtNet devices? Well, it's pretty simple, and in this video, I want to show you the basics of setting them up and go over some basic network options of what you need to do to make sure things get set up correctly. The first thing we're going to do is head to our 3-dot quick menu, into our main menu, and then go to DMX Setup. Under DMX Setup here, we have the output type, okay? We want to enable it, and if this is your first time setting up networking or you don't know whether to choose ArtNet or SACN, I would choose SACN labeled ACN here as your first option, okay? If you don't have experience with this, if your device will speak SACN, that's going to be my recommendation to you because it's generally more friendly and easy to work with. And on the LightShark, it gives us the full 8 universes. Press apply, and then you're going to need to restart the console. So press yes. Once you've restarted, let's head over to the network setup page. Under DMX streaming is where we're going to look next. Now, the DMX streaming port is the same as the Ethernet port, but this port can have 2 IP addresses so that you can separate control from your DMX streaming. Now, if that doesn't sound like something that is important to you, then it probably isn't for your application. But if you're working with a networking person to get things set up, they'll want to know this. Down here in DMX streaming, we want to set the IP address that we're going to send the DMX out on, okay, as well as the subnet mask. Now, what IP address should you use? Well, the very first thing is if you have just a simple network, you've connected a node or a few nodes to the LightShark directly or through a simple unmanaged network switch, then when you've got a simple network like this, and oftentimes this is all you'll need for a show, just go ahead and set the DMX streaming to the default, which is in the 2.xyz range, or like 2.0.0.1 or 2.0.0.2, etc. What you want to go for if you're new at this is just 2.0.0.something, and in that last digit, make it unique, make it different for each device on your network, and you'll be good to go. Now, by default, the LightShark console and LS nodes are all set to 2.0.0.1, and you can't have multiple of the same IP address on the same network, so be sure to configure those directly, which I'll go over in just a second. But regardless, if you're connecting to a larger network that already has IP addresses allocated, then you can put it in the range of your current network. For example, I'm on a network here in my office which has internet. I've set the IP address in the 192.168.0.x range, okay? Now, for ArtNet, I would not put ArtNet through this network, but SACN does work okay. Of course, if you're in a public facility on a public Wi-Fi, I would not do your DMX streaming on that network. In that case, if DMX streaming was open on the network, even if nobody else knew how to access the LightShark, they could still send data to your lights through other applications. Next, we have the subnet mask. If you don't know what you're doing with this, the default of 255.0.0.0 is good, but if you're connecting to a larger network again, you may know that you need to have it set differently. Press apply, reboot the console again, and now we're good with the console end of things, okay? Now the second half is to go to our node. In this example, I'm using a LightShark LS node 4. It has 4 ports and it's easy to use. All we need to do to configure it is set a few simple settings. The first being the device settings, okay? We need to set the IP address in that same range that we set the console. Now, for most closed show networks where you're just connecting a node directly to the console again, or have a few nodes with a simple network switch, you'll set this in the 2.xyz range, 2.0.0.something, okay? If you're on a network that has a router on it or is connected to the internet, you're going to need to make sure that the IP address range you're using matches the one that your router is using, or else it's not going to work right. Same with the subnet mask on the next line. With the subnet mask, again, keep it at 255.0.0.0 unless you know you have a reason to have it differently, at which point you're probably integrating it into a more complex network. Once that's good to go ahead to the port setup. We'll want to make sure each port is enabled, and then you can set the universe that you want the port to work with. This is going to correspond through universes 1 through 8 on the LightShark, which are patched. Be sure to note that if you are using ARTnet, ARTnet universes start at 0. And so if I'm using ARTnet, there is a universe 0. And if I'm in the LS nodes, it notes that universe 0 is the first universe. Be careful and read your manuals, because other devices that speak ARTnet, occasionally, some of them, will use universe 1 as the first universe. And so the universe 1 in the LightShark, which is ARTnet universe 0, will come in potentially as universe 1 on another manufacturer's piece of gear. Once you've got this all set up, save or whatever your ARTnet or SACN node has you do, and then you should see communication from the LightShark to your node. You're now able to plug in fixtures and go have a great show.